This is a WPBF 25 News special presentation, celebrating 26 years of holiday cheer and collecting toys for needy local families. This is the 2020 Marine Industries Association Palm Beach Holiday Boat Parade. Here is WPBF 25 News anchor Ron Burke.
We are coming to you from North Palm Beach on a beautiful night across South Florida. WPBF 25 is proud once again to partner with Marine Industries Association of Palm Beach County to bring you the brightest night of the year as brilliantly lit boats sail along the intracoastal waterway. Good evening and welcome to the 2020 Palm Beach Holiday Boat Parade, our 26th annual. I'm Ron Burke.
And I'm Alyssa Freeman with the Marine Industries Association of Palm Beach County. We are thrilled to have you with us tonight.
We have great energy in the area here right now in North Palm. The boat parade will start right here, and it will sail along the intracoastal waterway. And along the way, the great benefit of this event is what it does each year to spread joy and holiday cheer to young people, because toy boats will be picking up toys along the way, as we've seen in previous years, to distribute eventually to young kids this holiday season.
And this year, there are more than 50 boats in the parade competing for bragging rights and $10,000 in cash and prizes. So are we ready to get the show started?
Well, let's do it. Leading off the parade, as they do, as they have done in previous years, is everybody's favorite, Alyssa, the Zambelli Fireworks Barge. It's starting this event off with a bang, and we mean that in every sense of the word. Fireworks being shot off throughout the parade route.
Here they go.
The fireworks grand finale at the Jupiter Lighthouse, and look at them go.
Boat with our longtime Grand Marshals Mo and Sally from the Mo and Sally Morning Show on Cool 105.5 with some of their friends. The Grand Marshal boat looks a little different this year, but the boat has been in the parade before. Please welcome back the Thea Marie, operated by the Florida Fishing Academy out of the Riviera Beach Marina. The boat features a custom-made tree, manatees, turtles, dolphins, and ornaments. The Florida Fishing Academy is a 501c3 nonprofit organization formed in 2006 with a mission to change the lives of our youth through environmental stewardship, providing inspiration and education through recreation. Happy holidays from the Florida Fishing Academy, Marine Industries Association, and Mo and Sally from Cool 105.5.
I love the energy to start this parade with the fireworks display, and it's just such a great way. And the applause from the crowd, you can see they're into it as they began to see this procession of boats coming out. So we get our first look at boat number one in this parade.
This will be our first judged boat tonight.
It is the Blue Heron 2, part of the Blue Heron Fleet, owned by Ryan Nagel. He says his favorite part of the event is the fireworks, so he's in a great position to see those fireworks because he's pulling up right behind the opening boat. And they love being here because it spreads Christmas spirit and brings smiles to children. You look at this presentation, really elaborate, nice way to start this parade off, Alyssa.
They did a really nice job decorating this year. Love the music, love the energy.
Took six people 2 days to decorate the boat for this parade.
So a lot of people don't know, the parade travels through multiple municipalities in northern Palm Beach County, including North Palm Beach, Palm Beach Gardens, Juneau Beach, and Jupiter.
I hear some whistles, some applause. I think people like what they've seen so far.
All right, so next, we're gonna be seeing boat number two. Here it comes. They are a boat parade veteran with 3 years under their belt. It's 22-foot Teaser 2, owned by Scott Abel from North Palm Beach. Enjoying the parade atop Teaser 2 is a 20-foot long green turtle. A string of holiday lights dangle from its mouth as it experiences the festivities with the crew. That is a really cool looking turtle.
You know, I didn't know what that was at first, but yeah, I see it now.
It's
the
impressive.
More I look, the more I can see the turtle.
That is impressive.
I like that a lot. That's really creative. All right, boat number three is new to the parade this year. It's a 27-foot Sea Keeper, captained by Brian Mullinax, and the Sea Keeper staff. Took them a couple days to decorate this boat, and when he was asked what the boat parade means to him, he said in a year with so much uncertainty, this Palm Beach Holiday Boat Parade is a fun way for everybody to come together and recognize that in all we've gone through here in 2020, we're lucky to have this community event and each other to keep spirits high.
And then you
nice
see number four is a corporate entry for 22-foot The Detail Dude, who happens to be Ryan Daniello from Palm Beach Gardens and other members of The Detail Dudes. I think number five just went by too. Number five, Aqua Sooner.
Owned by Bill Kress of Palm Beach Gardens. They missed the parade last year, boat five, because of a wedding, and happy to be back. We're glad to have them back as well.
Number six, Ron, is 23-foot Boats and Homes, owned by realtor Christian Praca, so that's a pretty clever name. This is their first year in the parade. The boat's theme is Santa's sleigh. It took five people only one day to decorate. They've been part of the Boca Raton Holiday Boat Parade in past years, but they recently moved to North Palm Beach and are so excited to join us this year. Their favorite part about the boat parade is that it gets everyone in the Christmas spirit.
And that's really a common theme throughout, getting this start on the Christmas holiday spirit early here in December,
yes.
And they really gravitate toward that and embrace it.
We got boat number eight coming up here.
Okay, this is eight. This is One More Minute, owned by Angel Alvarez of Wellington. This is their third consecutive year here in the parade. Their theme is a dancing snowman. You can see the snowman atop the craft.
It's a nice looking snowman.
Some LED lights mixed in as well. They say their favorite part of the parade is to watch the other boats, parties, and support along the waterway, and especially crafting these lasting memories with friends and family, all for a worthy cause, the charities that benefit these children.
Absolutely. And something else that people might not know is that the parade route originally went through the Intracoastal Waterway in downtown West Palm Beach and Palm Beach. That's where it originally started from. And gradually, as the years went by, it made its way further north and now travels all the way to Jupiter, starting in North Palm Beach. Boat number nine, we can see right now, 30-foot Making It Count. On board is John Frost and his family from Wellington. Great name, by the way, John Frost. This is their fifth Palm Beach Holiday Boat Parade. Their favorite part of the parade is seeing all the other decorated boats and all the crowds along the waterway. It gets them all in the holiday spirit.
Joining us is my colleague from WPBF 25, Mike Lyons. He is on a boat with our photographer, Chris Mills. And let's check in with Mike for the first time and see where he is, who he's with, and how he's seeing this race from his vantage point. Good evening, Mike.
Good evening, Ron. It is a beautiful night. First off, the weather's spectacular. We had that weak cool front move through earlier today. Winds have shifted. The skies are mostly clear, temperatures are perfect, and we are upstream from you two, so we're getting a preview of the boats that you are about to see, and this is a spectacular show. I've covered this event, I don't know, 5, 6, 7 years in a row, and just amazed every year at how inspirational some of these boats are, some of the work that goes into it, and I'm telling you, you're going to be really pleased by what you're going to see in just a couple minutes. By the way, a lot of people are out socially distancing. They're watching the event. Again, the weather, it could not be better. Rod, back to you.
Mike, thank you so much. Enjoy it out there as we continue to watch this procession of boats. Boat 11.
Boat
just
11.
Passing by Suits to Us.
Yes,
Suits Us 2.
Suits Us 2 just passed us by, a former Best of Parade winner. They have amazing energy every year. And it's only their second year entering.
There are dozens of boats still to come plus a visit from the big guy himself, Santa Claus. You're watching the 26th annual Palm Beach Holiday Boat Parade. Welcome back. You're watching the 2020 Palm Beach Holiday Boat Parade. I'm Ron Burke with Alyssa Freeman. Look at the lights on Boat 12, a corporate entry food yacht operated by Justin Lindemann of Jupiter. Food yacht, as seen on Food Network, is Jupiter's number one water top dining experience with Chef Justin as his staff on board. It took four people about 4 hours to decorate. I would think longer with the number of lights they have on that boat. Good job.
That's a good job. So next we're gonna have boat number 13, another boat that's made an appearance in the boat parade for several years, and that is 24-foot Too Much Fun, operated by David Wiggins from West Palm Beach, along with some friends and family. This year, the boat honors our first responders. They're sporting a fire engine with help from the Minions. David says that the boat parade is the highlight of their year.
Nice theme. Next up is boat number 14, a 32-foot yellow streak operated by Zachary Ingram from Palm Beach Gardens. This is their fifth boat parade. Their theme is Christmas in Jupiter. The boat has thousands of lights on a light show, all synced to the Christmas music they're playing as they float along. They have a Santa sleigh, reindeer on the roof, lighthouse, lots of Christmas cheer built into that display.
It's a good looking boat. I love the chimney smoke. That's a nice touch. So much noise, so much energy.
The noise level just went up here.
The noise level just went up. This is boat number 15, carrying some familiar faces. 25-foot Misbehavin', owned by Jerry Ohnbrink from Hobe Sound. Jerry's one of our four-time Best of Parade winners. It took Captain Jerry and crew about a week to get the decorations for the boat perfect. The theme this year is Santa Sleigh, South Florida style. There are about 50,000 lights in total. To Jerry and crew, the boat parade is all about the kids and the sparkle the event brings to their eyes. The toy drive is also important for the less fortunate kids during the holidays. Jerry is confident that the community will donate a lot of toys this year, and I hope that he is right.
Yeah, boat 16 is a 44-foot Osprey. This is their fifth boat parade. The captain and crew are pleased to present their theme, which is Ocean Extravaganza. Look at that. That is really elaborate. It features, other than Mariah Carey's music, it features a scuba diver swimming in a shimmering blue sea with sharks circling and a happy dolphin keeping a watchful eye, as well as some colorful parrots. They really thought it through and put a lot of different elements into this colorful display.
That looks like it could be a placing boat. I think they could end up winning some sort of prize for that. That's really creative.
They invite anyone to sing along with them as they play, in this case, the All I Want for Christmas, very popular theme from Mariah Carey.
Love that song.
Took two electricians and six crew about 8 hours to decorate that impressive boat. They said they love spending quality time together to plan and decorate during the process.
So next, coming up here, we have boat number 17, 34-foot long shot, owned by former Palm Beach County Commissioner Warren Newell. The boat theme is Captain Santa. This is his first boat parade. The venture boat was built in Riviera Beach. On board is Captain Hank's father, former County Commissioner Warren Newell. Commissioner Newell is responsible for passing the boater's bond issue in Palm Beach County that protected dozens of waterfront properties and assisted in building new boat ramps, marinas, and waterfront parks across the county.
You're watching the 26th annual Palm Beach Holiday Boat Parade. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the 2020 Palm Beach Holiday Boat Parade. All right, we have a big one coming up here. Boat number 18 is a 66-foot Viking named Mission Fishing out of Jupiter. This is their first year in the parade, so we welcome Mission Fishing to the ranks. They're looking forward to putting a smile on a face or two, they say, and helping to bring the community together.
And I love their Hanukkah theme, too. That's really nice.
Mission Fishing.
The tree on the back is just beautiful.
That's a nice debut by them.
Next, we have boat number 19, 28-foot Eagle's Nest. This is their third year in the boat parade. Oh, holy night, the lights are brightly shining on Rudolph in the tropics. Please welcome Eagle's Nest and her enthusiastic crew. Captain Greg Andrews, along with wife Mary, daughter Courtney, and puppy Mango. Rudolph, with his nose so bright, will be lighting up the Florida Intracoastal Waterway for all to see. Merry Christmas and happy holidays to all. Their favorite part of the parade are all of the people along the waterway cheering from shore and the collection of toys from along the water. They say it's a great way to kick off the holiday season and give back to those in need.
Boat number 20 is next, 52-foot Real Lucky, owned by John Posatak from North Palm Beach. This is his third boat parade.
He's got a giant snowman head, I think, inflatable on the top of his boat. That looks really cool. People really love the inflatables. You see a lot of those. You see a lot of the inflatables.
They can really have a more animated feel when you get some breeze in the air, like we do right now, a little bit of a slight breeze.
Yeah, it feels really enliven their presentation. It feels so nice out here. It's wonderful. So the event only had about a dozen vessels in our first parade, which is crazy to think of that, because now look how many we have, 50, 60, some years 70.
It's come a long way.
I mean, it's a long, long way.
And like I said earlier, the energy is just fantastic. You can see that as we see here passing by now,
yes.
The music alone.
Number 21, this is number 21, 48-foot Lucky Dog from Lucky Dog Luxury Yacht Charters. It took three people one day to decorate. That's pretty impressive. On board is Captain Reed Hale and friends. This is his first boat parade, another first timer. Captain Reed has owned the boat for 4 years and has restored it to its former glory. The theme for this year is all about celebrating the holiday with exciting lights. A blue-white lighting theme is introduced to reflect the dark blue hull color of Lucky Dog. That looked really, really nice.
And the sound, I like that a lot.
And the sound systems on these boats are amazing. We can hear it loud and clear.
I have a feeling as the years go by, you mentioned 12 boats early on, that they're upping the ante in what they're presenting to the public here. Boat number 22 is a 20-foot Bad Girl owned by David Sakely out of Palm Beach Gardens. The theme is Miami Dolphins. Best part of the parade for David is collecting toys for the kids. He's in the right place for that.
Absolutely. So speaking of toys, 20 years ago, Toys for Tots made an announcement that donations were down for the year. And so one of our parade committee members had a vision that we could collect toys along the water the night of the boat parade. And this vision has come to life all these years later. And what once was a dream is now a reality. And we're just so happy that we can collect so many toys every year.
Welcome back. You're watching the 2020 Palm Beach Holiday Boat Parade. I'm Ron Burke with Alyssa Freeman.
Boat number 23 is sailing by right now. We don't get too many sailboats. This is 45-foot Miss Gypsy with the theme of sailing out of 2020. Kevin Jackson's on board with some family tonight. It took him a couple of evenings to hang and suspend lights and decorations. This is their second boat parade. Their favorite memory is moving from watching the parade from shore to participating by boat. And you hear a lot of these stories. People get involved with the boat parade after seeing it from the shoreline, and it's such a cool thing to hear about that.
And it catches on, and they want to be a part of it.
Exactly.
Really nice.
A lot of people tonight have their families on board, parents with their children, and this is an annual holiday tradition for them.
Up next, we have boat number 24. It's a 32-foot Gettin' Fishy, owned by the Quint family from Palm Beach Gardens. And they go with a strong snowman theme here.
Another snowman theme. I love it.
With American flag to the rear of the boat. This is their third boat parade. And they enjoy this event because it's a great family experience. Speaking to what you were talking about, Alyssa, we saw some young children on boats earlier as they were getting set for this parade here in our area. And a lot of enthusiasm on the part of the young people and the parents and the guardians as well. And this boat, I think, presents that nice family feel that they talk about in their description.
Absolutely. It is definitely a family affair. Number 25 you see coming up right now is 34-foot Triple Tail, owned by Russell Roswell from North Palm Beach. It took four people about a day to decorate. There is an inflatable, another snowman inflatable on top, and Christmas tree on the bow, on board with some friends and family. This is their first boat parade also. The family's watched it the last few years and decided it would be fun to enter.
Now that enthusiastic boat behind is boat number 26, 41-foot Diggin' Life, owned by Ron Taylor from Loxahatchee. It looks like they're having a nice gathering on board there.
And they did a great job decorating. I am
really
impressed.
That's a nice-looking boat.
Yes. Right behind them is boat number 27, 46-foot Aurelia, representing Pura Vida Divers, a scuba shop on Singer Island. The theme this year is Christmas Under the Sea, which is very fitting. Dean Schuler and his dive crew have been part of the parade for 3 years now. It usually takes about 4 hours to decorate with about a dozen helpers, so they have lots of helpers. The Palm Beach Holiday Boat Parade is one of their favorite ways to spend time with the crew and their families. They're usually very busy working dive charters and don't get a chance to relax and enjoy them.
It's a beautiful mix of colors. I like that a lot.
It is. They did a great job.
Now, take a really good look here at boat number 28. 30-foot Nailed It, owned by Aaron and Diane Lipscomb of North Palm Beach. Third year in the parade, and the boat's theme is Frosty and Friends, a beautifully constructed Frosty the Snowman and his friends at the base of that snowman. That is a spectacular display.
They did such a great job. Again, I'm going to call that they will win a prize this year. I think they're going to win something for sure. That looks amazing.
That's a 23-foot snowman at the center there, made with more than 7,800 LED bulbs, by the way.
Wow, 7,800. Right behind them is boat number 29. It's 25-foot Triple Threat, owned by Kimberly Snyder and James Gilchrist from Wellington. This is the inaugural year for their 11-year-old triplet boys, Tanner, Brady, and Justin. Huh. So now you know why they call it Triple Threat, right?
Bring them up early.
But they did the parade years prior to having kids. The theme of the boat is Disney Christmas. It took all five family members several days to prep and decorate.
There's still much more to come, including a visit from Santa. Stay with us. Welcome back. You're watching the 2020 Palm Beach Holiday Boat Parade. Boat number 30 is a 30-foot Always, owned by Leanne Taylor of Royal Palm Beach. The theme is reindeers. This is their second boat parade, and on board are Santa's elves, along with Lydia Keene and Phoebe. It took three people one afternoon to decorate that boat.
Now we have boat number 31, which is 22-foot J&J 2, owned by Jeff and Allie Meyer from Tequesta. There's no particular boat theme this year, just lots of holiday spirit. They're joined by some of their friends. This is actually their fourth boat parade. The favorite part of the event are the cheers from the spectators. We hear lots of those. And spending time with friends. It's their favorite way to ring in the holidays, Florida style.
Okay, 32 is up right now. That's Find the Fire, owned by Michael Hart from North Palm Beach. His theme is Aladdin Dancing Christmas. It's his second boat parade. When asked what the event means to him, he says it brings him community pride and helps him to honor the birth of Jesus.
And then following them, we have boat number 33, 24-foot Plan Z, owned by Reese Holly from Jupiter. Oh, he's got a speaker on his boat. This is their third boat parade. The theme of the boat this year is gratitude. It has many lights and handmade decorations. On board tonight with Reese and his wife are some friends and the family dog. Their favorite part of the parade is the enthusiasm from the people watching from shore. For Reese, the event is a celebration of Christmas in his place of birth, which is Palm Beach County.
Got the heart spreading the holiday love.
Love it.
Up next is boat number 34, 31-foot Fountain Center Console, owned by Dan Summer, Port St. Lucie. No particular theme, he says, just many LED lights. He decorated the boat himself in about 2 to 3 nights. His wife and 3 kids join him on board tonight. They've been part of the Martin County Boat Parade for 10 years, and this is their second in Palm Beach County. So they're beginning to make this a family tradition.
I love it. And those lights are so bright and beautiful. Simple, but very nice.
I like the movement in those lights, too.
Then we have boat number 37. There's a few boats in a row, but boat number 37 is a 23-foot seat hunt owned by Paul Stelius from Wellington. The boat features Santa on his sleigh with reindeer, multiple light themes, and a dancing polar bear. Gianna and Cassie are on board with him tonight, and this is their first parade. They look forward to making it part of their new holiday tradition for years to come. Not only does it allow everyone to give back to the community, but it's also really, really fun, they say.
Let's go back to Mike Lyons and see what he's seeing right now. Mike.
Well, Ron, Alyssa mentioned this earlier in the broadcast, really the dual purpose of the boat parade. One is we've got this fabulous boat parade. Who doesn't love a parade, especially one on water? With the boats going by, you get that Christmas spirit. Everyone comes out. You have a great time. And, of course, the other reason we're here tonight is the collection of toys. And Alyssa mentioned this earlier. I've been privileged to be on a boat in the past with a Marine going from dock to dock to dock here in Palm Beach County and collecting toys. And I'm always blown away by the generosity of the people here in Palm Beach County. Our boat would be full of every toy you can think of, especially bikes and that kind of thing. So it's really important, I think, to remember the dual purpose of this parade and to know that all those kids on Christmas morning are going to wake up to nice toys because of this boat parade.
You're watching the 26th Annual Palm Beach Holiday Boat Parade. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the 2020 Palm Beach Holiday Boat Parade. So we have some dancing Santa's helpers on board the boat coming our way now.
We're about to find out what number that is, and it is boat number 41. Yes. Wow, this is 56-foot timeout owned by Michael Slavin from North Palm Beach. The Slavins have been part of the boat parade for many years, but with a different boat. They are joined on board tonight with some of their closest friends. It took 2 people to decorate over Thanksgiving weekend. After leading the boat through numerous boat parades, Rudolph the Red-Nosed Dolphin was retired. The pandemic reminded them that life is short and we need to participate in events that make us happy. Rudolph has come out of retirement so that we can take some time out to dance and celebrate the holidays.
Nice job with the lights there accenting the boat and the dancers on top, really nice. Boat number 42 now. It's a 28-foot Leilani Rose owned by Tim Shivery from Wellington.
I see some inflatables on his boat as well. I think it's an elf. A chimney possibly on top. And right behind him, we have boat number 43, 22-foot Bloodline owned by Stephen Hyman from North Palm Beach. The Grinch has taken over. Captain of the boat tonight, the Grinch is not a fan of overly done Christmas decorations. This is their second year in the parade. Also on the boat is Amy Lee, Devin, Courtney, Robbie, and Heidi. They love to see all the holiday cheer from everyone gathering along the waterway to watch the parade and sing Christmas songs. They say that this year, the parade is a way to show that even in a year full of misfortunes, we are still able to gather responsibly and celebrate all that the holidays mean and the joy that it brings.
Up next, we have boat, I believe this is boat 39.
Yeah, this is boat 39. It's 45-foot all-in, owned by Donald Hansen from West Palm Beach, joined by some of his friends and family. The last time Donald participated in the parade was 2009, so it's been a few years for him, and he got back in it this year, which is really cool. It took three people one day to decorate. His favorite part of the parade is to raise money and toys for our great causes, of course, Toys for Tots and Little Smiles. They did a great job decorating.
Nice job. Up next, we have a boat 44, 28-foot participation award owned by the Turner family from Tequesta. This is their first year in the parade, so we welcome the Turner family. Their theme is The Grinch That Stole Christmas. Took four people about 5 hours to decorate. I've seen a few Grinches here, inflatable Grinches and what have you here. The family says that with 2020 being so crazy, the kids really wanted to get into the holiday spirit and enter the boat this year, so it was their idea, the children's idea, and they can't wait to have some family fun alongside the Grinch.
I love it.
Up next is boat 46, also includes an inflatable. It looks like a dancing inflatable Santa.
It does!
And he's dancing with people. This is I'm not sure how to pronounce that.
I would say Fluxentine.
Fluxentine 2, a 27-foot Grady White owned by John Kamer of Tequesta. This is the family's second Palm Beach Holiday Boat Parade. They're part of the Gulfstream Grady Group, and they're getting their groove on.
Yeah, right, that's now with Santa. That Santa is ho, not ho, ho. Stopping. He's having a great time.
Boat 36 is coming up next. And
another sailboat.
This one is a 44-foot Turtle Chaser sailboat. That's nice. You know what? Subtle,
yes.
Simple, essentially a singular color, but it works. It really pops.
It does work.
It really pops. 44-foot Turtle Chaser owned by Candy Maloney of North Palm Beach. The theme is a nautical classic white with a total of six 50-foot LED globe lights.
Wow.
Took two people 3 days to decorate. Candy's on board with Bill and some other Turtle Chaser friends. Their first year in the parade, so welcome to them.
Welcome. Wow, this next one, wow, boat number 49, 68-foot Madame Blue.
That's
so it is
really
a big
impressive.
Vessel, very impressive. Their theme is NASA Family Bling Bling Christmas. Mom Lisa spent around 35 hours decorating the boat. Dad Rory is captain and kids are the on-deck entertainment. The parade has become an annual family tradition, this being their sixth consecutive parade, the first on this boat. They love to make people smile and to help make the toy drive a huge success. Every year they strive to make the boat better and brighter than the previous year. And I think they accomplished that this year.
I believe that. Yeah, that is a really nice job of decorating.
They
have the movement
job.
In the lights, some stationary lights. Well done. Boat 52 is up next. A 76-foot burger from Adam Cara Charters LLC. On the boat is Claudia LeCompte and friends. This is their first boat parade.
Another first. I love it. And that's another large boat, too.
Again, subtle.
Subtle. Classic.
Pretty, almost a singular light display, but they have some lighter colors, some off-white colors, and really nice as they sail down or up the intercoastal.
That's great.
Really nice. It's almost that time. When we come back, Santa arrives in Palm Beach County. Welcome back. You're watching the 2020 Palm Beach Holiday Boat Parade. I'm Ron Burke with Alyssa Freeman.
Got some more music coming.
I hear the Jackson 5.
Another very large vessel. This is the fourth year with the Boat Parade's partnership with Little Smiles. I know that anchor boat is coming.
I'm enjoying hearing Michael Jackson sing. They've got the reindeer out
and
front.
Speaking of Little Smiles, this is perfect timing because this is boat number 60. This should be the last boat in the parade. And Santa is on the back. There he is waving. Santa Claus joined us all the way from the North Pole tonight to join us for the Palm Beach Holiday Boat Parade. He's on the floating sleigh this year. The mission of Little Smiles is to help kids be kids during difficult times in hospitals, hospice, and foster care. But during the holiday season, they changed their mission to help any child and any family in need.
As always, Santa making a dynamic entrance, as it should be, getting everybody into the Christmas spirit as he closes out this 2020 Palm Beach Holiday Boat Parade, a perfect traditional finishing touch.
Yes, the perfect finish.
And many children in our area will benefit greatly from the charity and the well wishes of everyone involved in this boat parade. We say thank you to everyone who contributed toys to children to brighten their holiday spirit here in 2020. And we certainly need a lot of brightening to close out this particular calendar year, don't we? That's going to conclude our 26th annual Palm Beach Holiday Boat Parade. Thank you again for being with us. It's always a joy. We enjoyed it thoroughly and enjoyed having you with us. I'm Ron Burke here with Alyssa Freeman. Merry Christmas and happy holidays from all of us at WPBF 25 and the Marine Industries Association of Palm Beach County. We wish you a happy holiday season. Be well.